welcome to the last part of our arena tutorial. In this episode, we will combine all previous elements into a quest with a timer. First, open the quest file. We'll use a file previously made for this tutorial. Our waves are supposed to go off the moment the siren is activated. That's we need a use phase. This phase interprets usable objects as parameters. In this case, it's our trigger of the physical switch DI class. As always, we type in its unique name and the state parameter, which determines to which state the player is supposed to switch the trigger. Our trigger is turned off, so we need to select on, as we want the player to activate the trigger. Next, we add the timer to our quest. The player's objective will be to survive within the time limit. For that, we need two phases. The first one is a logic phase, or, which allows for branching the quest. It's made of paths that are being realized simultaneously during the game. We need two of them. Phase or is finished when one of the paths is completed. In our quest, one path is timer, which when it reaches zero, ends the quest. The other path is survival, that is killing all AI enemies. If the player survives, it finishes the second path before the timer doesn't end the quest. We will also need to add two parameters. The first parameter is time in seconds, while the other one determines if the quest is to be stopped when the time is up. The survival path will use phase kill multi. This phase, unlike kill, lets us use more than one spawner. Phases are finished one after another. This is why we need to use kill multi phase three times to have three waves. Let's add objectives to each phase and attach the spawners. In order to add spawners to phase kill multi, we need to add them in new verses, starting with spawner. Let's add all our spawners to each kill multi phase. The player will need some rest, so we should also make short breaks between waves by using the wait phase. Okay, the waves are ready. Now we can prepare the conclusion of our quests that will disable our playable area and the siren. The playable area can be disabled with the disable phase. Use it on the playable area controller. Disable the siren with phase set and changing its state to off. Let's compile the quest and see if everything's alright. We can see one of the phases lacks an objective. Let's add it now so that the player knows what to do. The first phase of any quest needs to have an objective. Alright, so let's compile everything once again and check our quest in the game. You can climb the wall, check. You can't leave the area without being brought back, check. Everything seems fine, so let's activate the siren and start the first wave. To save some time, we will kill them all with the keyboard shortcut Alt-K. Let's jump to the second wave of virals. Virals have come, which leaves only bombers. And here they are. After killing the bombers, the quest is completed and the player can leave the playable area without any problems. And that concludes our series of episodes focused on building arena. Thank you all for watching.